When it comes to displaying website widgets, or essentially the content, you're going to be using text, spacers, dividers pretty often, and sometimes creating custom forms. So let's drag and drop each of these widgets onto the page and show you how you can manipulate each one. So text is essentially paragraph text of some kind. This is different than a heading, which is more of just a title like this. That's more of just something bold, 1 to 2 lines, and at most a sentence in length. If we're looking for more paragraph text, that's when we want to use the text editor. Now there's a couple different ways I can edit text. I can type in here, change the font size and so forth, or I can actually come in here to text settings and then manipulate the text and have, you know, the same exact resources, but a little bit more. Now the text itself, this is just the text portion, and then we actually can start manipulating other parts of the widget, just like every other widget, when it comes to the background. It could be a solid color, it could be an image, we can give this text box a border, we can give it a shadow. When it comes to layout, the primary ones you'll sometimes use are margin and padding. Margin creates space above and below and left to right of all of the blue area that's within the box, and then padding itself creates space within the blue and the actual content itself, in this case the text. We could give, just like any other widget practically, we can give it an entrance animation where it can fly in, appear, and so forth, depending on what we're really looking for. Text is one of the more straightforward types of widgets. It's just going to be something that you're going to use when you're using bulk amounts of paragraph content that you're trying to upload. Now, what is very different than kind of pure text is using the form widget. The form widget is more or less often used to gather contact information. So on the Contact Us page by default, we have a form just like this. And we could control all of the information we are collecting, the order that it is collected, and how much detail, what we want to require. It's essentially putting together a custom form, just like you would imagine. So again, just like we had with the text, we have the design capabilities, but we can control a little bit more, so I can start controlling this button color down here. This is just, again, the layout of the content. But the background and the layout here are very similar. But then within the properties of this form is where I can start manipulating, again, the variables that we are collecting. So we have name, and then you can see it even says first, and then it'll say last. So we can come into configure and then essentially customize what all this displays and so forth. So again, it's required. And if we want to add an additional, we can come down here to add, and then here's all the different types of form ways of collecting information. A lot like custom fields, we can create some radio buttons, checkbox, and so forth that allows us to create multiple selection options for the customer and have them tell us what they're looking for from there. Forms are actually, they're really not that complicated. There's just a few more settings to think about. Now again, what's more common than using the form widget would be to use either the spacer or the divider widget. So a lot of the times, as far as making a website look nice, we want to space out the content and sometimes use divider lines and so forth to just create nice, elegant looking aspects to the website. So a spacer is exactly what you would think it is. It essentially allows us to create space in between content. There's really not much you're going to do. I mean, you can control, like I said, with a lot of the other widgets, the background, the layout, and so forth, but most of the time this spacer is just something you're going to just drag around and find how much space you're trying to add between two widgets. And then again, a lot like the spacer is actually the divider. So I'll bring the divider in here and realize that 3 is actually pretty heavy. I mean, if you go down to 1, it's still, I mean, it's not the thickest line, but it's still a pretty thick line. So you can completely control how thick you want it to be, the color, and then the actual style. And like the other widgets, have these other settings that you can configure as well. In this case, this is within a column. So if I want to make the widget display full page, I would have gone to the row, layout, stretch, and this would be content in this case. We'll do the background as well, and then we'll be able to start going the full length. Hopefully you find this video helpful. Thank you for watching.